Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements video, we'll be making a custom snowflake brush and then using that to make this snowflake background. Now, if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button and, of course, click on share. Also, don't forget to subscribe. I do a bunch of videos every single week. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. You'll learn a lot more there than you will in these short YouTube videos. Okay, let's get to it. To do this Photoshop Elements custom brush effect back here, we'll first make one snowflake brush. Let me just bring that up here, just like this. And we'll then use this to make another brush, which has a bunch of snowflakes on it. And we'll use that brush to do the background. Okay, let's go ahead and get started on this stuff. Just save that, get that out of the way, that out of the way. We'll start off with a brand new file here, file, new, blank file. What you want is a 2-inch by 2-inch file at 300 pixels per inch, right there. Then just choose OK. There we go. So here's our basic file. Now set your foreground color to black if it isn't already. And then we need to find the center of this page. We'll need to have our guides up here and our rulers. So if you don't see rulers, go up to view and make sure that rulers is checked right there. Also make sure that guides is checked so we can get our guides. Now just grab the ruler and pull straight down and you'll pull a guide onto the page. Now if you pull down slowly, you'll see it snap to the center of mine. There it is. Okay, do the same thing here with the vertical guide. I'll pull it in and wait for it to snap on the center point. There it is. Now if they don't snap for you, double check snap to at guide is selected and that grid selector as well. They should all be selected by default. Just go ahead and do those again. But they'll snap to the center line. If you have guides or document bounds or layers, any of those, they should snap to the center line. But again, usually these are set to all checked, just like that. Okay, there's our center point. Now we'll make the beginning part of our snowflake. Let's go over here and grab this tool. This is the line tool. You might see something like this up here. Just click on that and then come down here and choose a line right there. I have mine set at black. That's the foreground color. And I have this set at 4 pixels and no arrowhead. So that should say no arrowhead. Okay, then come onto the center here, find your center point. It doesn't need to be perfectly exact, but basically on your center. And then pull straight out to the right until you're near the right-hand side. Not actually on it, just near the right-hand side like that. That's the first part of this. Now for the next part, come over here right towards the middle and come onto that middle line. And then begin pulling up kind of in a diagonal way like this. Then hold the shift key down and that should snap to an exact 45 degree diagonal. So let's pull a few of these out. Again, it's like that, then hold the shift key down for an exact diagonal. Do a couple of short ones down towards the middle in here. And then come over here some ways, do a little bit of a longer one like that. And then just a few more in here. Now these can be spaced differently apart. They don't have to be exactly the same spacing on these things. You can kind of vary them around a little bit, and you may want to do a few different and see what you come up with. You know, go ahead and experiment a little bit. So I'll do something kind of like that. Maybe I'll do one more, just a little short one right here at the end. There we go. Just a few of those little short lines. There we go. And this gives you a whole bunch of these shapes over here on the layers panel. The top one is selected. I'll hold the shift key down, click on the bottom shapes. All the shapes are selected like that. I don't want the background selected, just the shapes. Right click and choose merge shapes. This all becomes just one layer now. Now right click on this layer and choose duplicate layer and OK. And it comes right on top. So go up to image, come down to rotate and do flip layer horizontal. It just reverses that. Now using the move tool over here and then just the arrow keys, I'll just move this to the left, just holding down the left arrow key, and I'll push this clear over to the left until the end just meets at that middle point. I'll go a little bit past like that so I can see it, and then I'll tap in again on the right arrow key until those meet right there. Okay. Now same thing, top layer, shift key, next layer, and then merge those together, right click, and merge shapes. Make another copy of this, right-click duplicate, okay. This time go up to image, come down to rotate and flip vertical, and it does that for you. Again, using the arrow keys, let's just pull this down, the down arrow, and pull it down until it just matches that one. There we go. Same thing again, select both of those layers, right-click and merge shapes. One more time here, duplicate layer, choose OK. Now this time, use the Control T keyboard shortcut that brings up our transform options down below here and change the degrees to 60 and click the check mark right there. Now copy that layer, right, duplicate, there we go. Same thing, Control T keyboard shortcut, come down to your degrees, make that 60 again. And hit that. And that's our basic snowflake shape right there. Let's now merge these layers together, right-click and merge shapes. Okay, now we're going to give some thickness to this snowflake. So first up, hold the Control key down, click on the thumbnail for that layer. That selects all the contents, in this case just those lines for the snowflake. Now come down to the background layer and make a new layer so it comes in right above the background like that. So our selection is on this new layer now. Go up to Select, come down to Modify and Expand right here, and then set this at 4 pixels and choose OK. It's just a little bit wider. I'll now hide that top layer so you can see there's our selection. Click on the black foreground color and set this about here, about a third of the way up. Choose OK. Doesn't need to be exact. Using the paint bucket, click inside that selection and that makes that kind of a thing here. Come back to the background, make a new layer right here. There you go. Our selection is still running. Go back up to Select, come down to Modify, come down to Expand, and this time set this at 16 pixels and choose OK. That's a lot wider as you can see in there. Go back to your foreground color and come back up so we're about a third from the top, two-thirds from the bottom, kind of a light gray. Choose OK. Let's hide that layer. And then make sure you're on the right layer here. Click inside this and that fills up with a lighter gray. We can now go ahead and deselect that and then show all those layers. So that's the basic paintbrush in here. Now we'll be painting with a black paintbrush, but we'll be using white paint, which is where we get our nice white snowflake from. Let's now convert this into a brush. Go up to the Edit menu and come down to Define Brush right here. Give it a name. I'll call this one Snowflake 4. I've already done a few of these here, just playing around. Choose OK. So now I have a brush that's named Snowflake 4. Okay, let's now make a new file, File, New, blank file. It should still be at the 2x2 and 300 pixels. That should be okay. Choose All Right, there we are. Just dock that. Here's our new file. Reset your foreground background colors to black in the foreground. Grab your paintbrush, and it should automatically be on that new snowflake. Now you're only seeing the whole outside. If I click on this though, you'll see the whole thing. There it is. Let's just undo that. We're now going to use the left bracket key and bring the snowflake down quite a bit in size. Just kind of like that. Just do one here and I'll do one down here someplace. Tap that down a bit more, so it's about half that size. And let's do a few like this around. Bring it down size some more. Again, that's tapping on that left bracket key. There we go, and real small, just do a few real small ones around. Now don't go over the edge. Make sure you don't overlap the edge. Everything has to be inside of that edge. Just a few of these just for effect. Just randomly around the page like that. Okay, there we go. Let's now save this as a brush also. So back up to Edit, come down to Define Brush. I'll call this one Snowflakes. And one, choose OK. And you can see there's that brush right there. Okay, we have our snowflake brush. Now we're ready to do our snowflake picture. Let's do File, New, Blank File. I'll set this one at the default Photoshop Elements size, which is a 6x4, 300 pixels. Choose OK. I'll just dock that in place. There we go. Let's fill this with a gradient. Go over to your foreground color, click on that, and come over in here, kind of midway into your blue range, and then come down rather low on the right-hand side, about two-thirds of the way down, right-hand side. Just a real dark blue. Choose OK. Now click on the white background. Brings back up the color picker. This time use the little eyedropper. You can see it right there. And click on that foreground blue. So it reselects that blue, and then come over here about the same distance. Now it's a bit too purpley, I think, here. So I'm going to pull this down a bit so I get rid of some of that purple. Right about there. That's pretty good. Just a nice kind of light blue. Choose OK. So a dark blue to light blue. Let's now go up here to the gradient tool, and you should see the dark blue, light blue as a gradient right down there. If you don't click on that little arrow, it should be your top left-hand corner. Make sure on the left-hand side here, this is the linear gradient, and come just inside the top. Hold the shift key down and pull it straight down. The shift key makes sure that it gives you a perfectly straight or vertical gradient. Pull to the bottom, let go, and there's our gradient. Let's now put some snowflakes in here. Let's change our colors back to black and white. Let's invert those colors so white is in your foreground. Go back to the brush tool. Okay, now let's make a new layer above our background layer. New layer button right here. There we go. This will be our snowflake layer. Come over here someplace and just click once here and then down here and click again. There's snowflakes just tapped on by using this brush. Now don't pull it or you get that. You don't want that. So let's just undo that. So make sure you just tap it once. Now come down where it says brush headings down here. And where it says angle, just grab that arrow and just move it down a little bit. And that's going to rotate the brush around a little bit so it's not quite exactly the same place each time. So just go through here and just a little bit of this, just come in, rotate your brush, put a few more snowflakes in, rotate your brush around some more, put in a few more snowflakes, and then do one more rotation on this like that. Click on brush settings and I'll put one right there. So there's our snowflake background. Okay, now that's all set. Let's go ahead and bring in our picture. Now I already have what I'll be using for this. Let me just bring that up over here, recently edited files. And I got that one right there. If you want to use this same image for practice, there's a download link for this image. You'll find that in the description, of course. Okay, grab that background, just drag it over here. Now if you don't have floating windows like this, just go up to Edit, come down to Preferences and General, and click right here, Allow Floating Documents in Expert Mode. Choose OK. It'll then come in floating, allowing you just to drag and drop. If you don't want to do that, you always can just go up to the File menu and come down to Place, and then use that to place your image into your file. And let's just get this position about right. That looks pretty good right there. Now we need to remove her background and leave just the snowflakes in behind. So for that, I'll go up to the lasso tool, and I'll do a lasso, just a quick little lasso just outside of her hair here. I'm not going to be worrying about those little feathery things. We'll take care of that in just a bit. Okay, just inside like that, and then back to the beginning. Now I missed a little corner right down here, so click on Add, and I'll just do a circle around that, and that adds that in. Okay, where it says feather, have that set at 1 pixel. Come to Refine Edge, and here's the Refine Edge tool right there. In here, click on Smart Radius. I usually have my set on Overlay, it's just easy to do. And then there's your brush. It's at 35, and I found most of the time that's pretty good. You can change your brush size right here if you want to, though. Now on this brush, paint right along that edge of that red mask, and just do that a few times and work your way in to the hair. And that will help you get those little thin hairs. There we go. Just kind of work your way around, just little short strokes. Now this in part here, this inside part, you'll need to work into that like this. It will eventually work for you. And once you get some nice background pink color showing in there, you're okay. All right, same thing. Let's just go around the whole figure. And I'll make sure I come in and get those little thin areas. Let's do this side up here. When you work in like this, just kind of slowly working your way in, it's gives you the best chance to get all those little thin hairs. Okay, let's work around this side. So we're just about done, actually. Okay, around this, again, outside, and then work the way in. Like that. And those little interior parts that start outside and pull in to get something into those interior sections. It usually works out very well. Okay, so there is our refined edge. Come down to Output 2 and changes to New Layer with Layer Mask. Choose OK. There's the new layer with the layer mask right here. It hides the original layer. Our background is now gone, and we can see through those hair areas. Now, it's a little bit thick right here still. We're not really seeing through right there. So for that, click on the layer mask side. You should see a light blue outline around that. There we go. Go over here to this tool. This is the burn tool. You might be seeing that. Just come down to your options. Click on this little hand right there. That's your burn tool. You can kind of see my circle. There you go. See right there. And then just come in and paint right into that area on the layer mask. That darkens on the layer mask right there and allows you to see through. If you want to adjust the values or colors on your portrait, now's the time to do it. Go up to Layer, come down to New Adjustment Layer. I'll use Levels in here. Where it says use previous layer to create clipping mask, make sure that is checked. Choose OK. And I'll bring the contrast up. I'll bring the darks in a little bit and the lights in a little bit and just increase my contrast. Looks pretty good right here. Let's just check the values. I think that's pretty good. Now, if you want to lighten up the snowflakes, I think these look fine. But in case you want to lighten them up, there's one way to do that. This is white on a clear layer, so you can't use the levels on that. So come down to the layer. This is our snowflake layer. Right-click. Choose Duplicate Layer and OK. And that doubles up that layer and makes those a lot brighter. If they're too bright, just bring the opacity down on that second layer. Right here, I'll bring it down to halfway, 50%. So this allows you to control how bright those snowflakes are by just overlapping those two layers. Okay, there you go. That's it. That's our custom snowflake background. Now, if you had fun with this video, make sure you hit that like button. Also, don't forget to click on that share button. That really helps my channel out. And don't forget to subscribe as well. I do new videos every single week. And take a look at my complete training course. It's right down there in the description. And I teach you everything about working with Photoshop Elements, not just these few things that we do here on YouTube. Okay, I'll see you next time.